Les villes concentrent aujourd'hui plus de la moitié de la population mondiale.
More than half the global population lives in town, and towns produce 80% of wealth, 70% of the consumed energy, and more than is consumed in towns, and more than 70% of CO2 emissions also can be attributed to towns. Towns, therefore, are home to more than 80% of the population, and they consume the largest part of the energy consumed across the world. Energy stakes can be felt in town more acutely, and urban planning therefore plays an essential role in the energy transition. We can talk about moving from a system based essentially on the use of fossil fuels, which release greenhouse effect gases, oil, gas, and coal, to a mix of energies where renewable energies are used more and energy efficiency is increased. What are the solutions contemplated to integrate renewable energies in urban spaces and participate in a more sustainable urban development? The first option that was explored is that of smart cities, where smart grids are developed. Now, the concept of smart city refers to integration of information and communication technologies in town. The town is connected. In the smart networks developed within this project will connect or interconnect all of the users who sometimes also produce electrical power in order to achieve better management, delivery and production of electrical power. The production sites can be decentralized and multiplied. They are placed in a network and the electrical power is shared on the network, on the grid, and distributed in real time depending on the user's needs. Jeremy Rifkin says that smart grids are the internet of energy. The smart grid produces electrical power, redistributes it depending on the need, and adjusts offer and demand while integrating the production of renewable energies. There are several options to develop smart grids. This can be achieved in existing urban districts. This is done, for instance, in Nice with the so-called Nice Grid project. A demonstrator of a smart solar district in Carros, on the western side of Nice, the Nice city. 200 volunteer households produce electricity with solar panels, photovoltaic panels on their rooftops. And in this district called Carros, energy storage systems have been developed with very large batteries in the district and smaller batteries within the household. Electrical smart appliances are also developed within the houses in order to interconnect the houses with the other houses, thus generating a huge smart connected grid, thanks to IT resources. There is another example, another option where a smart grid can be implemented when new districts are being developed and built. For instance, in Japan, there is the Fuisawa Sustainable Smart Town. And here, the project focuses on solar energy production and renewable energy production, and also the individual storage of electrical power. The smart grid, the IT grid, allows to optimize production and distribution management. There is another option to develop renewable energy production within urban territories, the urban heating networks, for instance, in France, following the Grenelle de l'environnement decisions, national ambitious objectives were set for the Horizon 2020 to connect more houses with the heating network and also bring the renewable energy to a higher proportion. Now, the heating network is a distribution system located on the intermediate scale of the district or part of the town. It's neither totally centralized, as would be the case in the nuclear energy system, nor totally centralized, as could be the case with the solar individual production options. Thanks to a heat production unit, heat will be distributed to a number of buildings through a primary network with substations and secondary networks. The buildings could be houses, office buildings, public administration buildings. Ever since the year 2000, heat networks have given precedence to renewable energy to fuel their needs, to feed their needs. This was done across the 20th century during the various stages of urban planning, but we see now an increased approximately one-third of the 450 existing heat networks are fueled by renewable energies. However, a number of local administrations have decided to convert their heat networks to also feed them with renewable energy sources. This is precisely what happened when a new district was developed, the Ginkgo Eco District in Bordeaux. The decision was made to create a boiler, a heat network fed by a wood-burning boiler, wood supplied by local forests, in order to cover 100% of the need for heating in this area with renewable energies and wood. Heat networks can integrate renewable energies in already existing urban areas. Towns are renewing themselves very slowly. Only 1% is renewed every year with new buildings. So waiting to develop a new district is not sufficient. In order to meet our objectives, we have to do something in existing urban areas. This is the decision made by Orléans. They converted two existing heat networks, which were fueled by gas or diesel oil, and converting them to renewable energies. The heat networks are now fed by boilers where wood is burnt, the wood being supplied by local forests, and one quarter of the population is heated with wood burning boilers. Other towns are also embarking on more ambitious projects. Some of them want to cover 100% of the energy needs with renewable energies. For example, the Masdar City project in Abu Dhabi. This is a new town designed by Norman Foster, the British architect office. The ambition being that this town will consume, will release no emissions and will release no waste, and 100% of the energy consumption will be fueled by renewable energies, for instance, by developing the use of photovoltaic panels to produce electrical power, by producing water, domestic water with solar boilers, and sweet water is supplied by desalination power plants, and finally transportation is also encouraging electrical means of transport with the renewable photovoltaic electrical power, replacing progressively internal combustion engines with electrical buses and automated electrified transportation means. Some existing towns beyond these ambitious projects, some existing towns also are aiming at increasing the share of renewable energies in their efforts to cover their needs. Tisted in Denmark is a federation of 11 towns. Starting in the 80s, they developed a very ambitious policy to develop renewable energy consumption, and the results are spectacular. particular, 100% of the electrical power consumption is covered by renewable energies, for instance, wind energy. And 85% of the energy needed for heating of the 46,000 inhabitants is covered by renewable energies, especially the incineration of domestic waste. Another example can be given of a federation of municipalities that develop ambitious objectives. The federation of Perpignan in 2008 they signed a convention with the state, whereby in 2015 Perpignan will be the first positive energy town 100% based on renewable energies in Europe. These ambitious objectives went through the development of renewable energy of various origins. In this federation of municipalities, they developed wind farms, but photovoltaic farms, both on the ground but also on rooftops, especially on the rooftop of the local market hall in Saint-Charles or the new TGV high-speed train rail station. And also by recovering energy
la valorisation, disons, de l'énergie tirée de,
from an local incineration plant where they incinerate household waste. We understand, therefore, that there is a close connection between urban planning challenges and energy consumption challenges, which means that we have to think in a coordinated way between energy transition et and urban planning.